Want to learn about five fantastic alternatives to using AliExpress in 2019? I'm going to teach you how now. Alternative number one, private suppliers. So here's some pros. You have a supplier who is going to help you source the highest quality product for the cheapest price. You're going to get faster shipping. Okay, because you're working straight with the manufacturer, you don't have to go to a supplier. You're going to have faster shipping because there's no processing times. It's pretty much same day processing to then ship your product. And they've usually got faster shipping methods than just e-packet. They can stock the items for you. So these private suppliers can either help you find a warehouse or they actually have their own where they can stock it for you and actually ship it for you. And you may have direct contact with them. They have direct contact with the supplier. Communication with them is very quick and easy. A lot of them are just, they're on Skype, they're on WeChat, they're fantastic and very responsive because it is their entire occupation and their reputation hinges on it. And you can brand your products, okay? So with these people, it's so much easier to get your business card or product actually stamped with your actual brand name on it. That makes a big difference. The cons of this is you need to find them, obviously. You can find them on Upwork. They cost about $20 to $30 USD per hour and can take up to about 10 hours because it takes time to go through their networks and find and negotiate the best prices. You need to have a minimum order value or MOQ, okay, minimum order quantity, and it can be literally $1,000 worth or more. It just really is dependent, but $1,000 is sort of the standard. It does create a little bit more extra work, meaning that you need to use a CSV. Okay, so you can use Exportify to export it and then mass fulfill when you import it. Okay, so you need it because you need to import it as well because they'll give you the tracking numbers. And if you don't, obviously, if you buy $1,000 worth of stock, but for some reason the product dies within that time, then you can be out of pocket. Okay, so I'm just going to show you now how you can find. So you can just jump on Upwork. You can see I'm just here on Upwork on my account. And you can see you've got all these sourcing agents, okay? So $25, $35, $10. It's up to your budget. For me, I go off by quality. Like I use their success rate and how much they've earned. So if they've earned like $5,000 and they have that good success rate, they're pretty good. You know, if they've earned a lot more or whatever, there's heaps of different ones. So I recommend putting up a job posting for these. It works really well. You're then going to get, because a lot of these you're not going to find here, and because if we have a look at the filters, you know, you can go in the top 90% with at least 10k earned. Okay, that's what I like to do because I want really quality ones, because again, I'm all about, so look at that, $15 for a virtual assistant who also is a sourcing agent, 50k earned, $15 an hour, 100% success rate from Vietnam. Now, that is something to keep in mind. I found sometimes that they're better from China, but either way, for $15 an hour with how much she's clearly doing something really well. Okay, so I just wanted to show you that that's how you can find a sourcing agent. If you do otherwise need a sourcing agent, I am actually happy to provide my sourcing agent. Just comment down below if you want my sourcing agent, and then we can talk on Instagram. So I can DM you the person's details on Instagram. She's alternative number two, Amazon. Okay, so this is one of my actual favorite ones. Extremely fast shipping. Shipping is a massive upsell that you can charge premium for. Okay, they're reliable suppliers. Amazon FBA are very specific, fulfillment by Amazon, sorry, are very specific with who they let on the platform, and you can easily find suppliers. I'm going to show you how in a moment. They're high quality products. Again, in order for them to be competitive, because Amazon is primarily a US market, they have to be high quality products. They provide excellent customer service, so they respond really quick, especially if they're a good business on Amazon. Low chargeback rate as a result. We get easier returns and exchanges as a result. More repeat customers because of this. And it's great for selling just generally in the US, okay? The cons, obviously, is it's more expensive, okay? So, you know, you can buy a dog collar on Amazon for $3 and it might be, on AliExpress for $3, but on Amazon it might be $10, $12, okay? Big difference. Manual processing of orders. So generally speaking, that you'll have to manually process them. It's not for those who are needing cash flow immediately. So if you're someone that you need to start making that money, you can't justify having very, very thin margins even for testing, then this is probably not the best option. And some people may ask you as well just why it is from Amazon. It's few and far between, but you will get a few of those. So I'm just going to show you how. All right, so I'm on Amazon, and you all know I love dogs. So we can see here we've got these different forms of LED dog collars, right? So let's say this is a branded product, but the good thing, obviously, with Amazon is that we can see their reviews. And the reviews is, you know, an indication of how well they are. So if I was marketing this dog collar, okay, we can see it has 13,000 customer reviews, okay, with a 4-star rating. That's perfect. There's no way that you cannot get that. See how it's very heavily skewed? That's what's going to happen. And all you do is you make an Amazon account, you fulfill the order and gift it to them. Okay, so you basically gift it to that address and you can buy it through there. And how, again, what you do on Amazon is you find your product, you go off by the one that has the most amount of reviews in that, for that type of product. Just try and find the one with the most amount of reviews. Use them, because if they've already gotten tons of reviews, okay, and they're 4 or 5 stars, 4.5 stars, then they're going to be a good supplier. They're going to provide excellent customer service, and they're going to provide a good quality product with fast shipping, which is a big difference that we can use on our Facebook ads. So you may be wondering at this point in the video, why use AliExpress? You know, why not use AliExpress? I wanted to describe the pros and the cons. So AliExpress is great for beginners who's starting on a light budget, who, you know, are learning, and that's understandable. It comes with a variety of apps like DSERs, Overload, Dropfied. There's tons of apps out there that allow you to use AliExpress, because that's the main one, okay? You don't need any technical knowledge, okay? You don't need to hold stock yourself. And you can automate a lot of the workflows in a lot of these apps because it's so heavily used. They put a lot of work into it. And you can find nearly any product you need to get started on AliExpress. However, the cons are that the suppliers have a 20% surcharge, okay? So at least a 20%. So if you're seeing an item for $4, they'll be at least adding, you know, probably about $1 or something. And then they add a little bit more again on the shipping, okay? So that they can make their piece of the pie. This is the way it works. Finding a reliable supplier can be difficult on AliExpress. AliExpress has regular maintenance issues, especially as of recent, and security issues. So if, once you start fulfilling a number of orders, a number of your orders, you actually, for some reason, won't be able to fulfill them and won't let you. You have to like upload your driver's license, your passport, or some form of identification. It can take days, and it's a, you know, you don't want that, because that then means that you can't even process your order to even get it shipped. Okay, it doesn't accept all forms of payments. Okay, it can be a pain like that as well, depending on what country you're from. So it's important to keep in mind. A lot of people ask, can it use PayPal? Unfortunately, at this point in time, it can't. Some can, some, okay, but mostly no. E-packet is getting more expensive, and a lot of people, so e-packet is a form of shipping, okay, becoming more expensive, whereas using other methods, you actually can get better shipping. It has 2 to 3 week minimum shipping, okay? So depending on the country, it can be less, but generally it's 2 weeks minimum, okay? Customers are getting over longer shipping times, okay? So e-packet 2-3 years ago was fine. Now that so many people are marketing, it is becoming, unfortunately, a problem, okay? Returns are a real pain, okay? So returns to your supplier can be a real pain. Customer has to pay that as well. They can pay $5-$10 for that just to return the item to even get their money back. And a lot of the times they won't do it. They're just going to get really angry. They can even do chargebacks. And trust me, chargebacks are not what you want. Speaking to many suppliers that on AliExpress, English is not their first language. Okay. On a lot of other platforms like Upwork, for instance, they're native English speaking, because Upwork is primarily, most of the customers that are people like us, we're English speaking individuals, okay? So English to them is mandatory. There's even courses for that on that platform, okay? So I just wanted to explain that so you have some understanding of any doubts and the pros and cons. I hope you have been enjoying today's video. Don't forget to subscribe to today's video and comment down below, crush it, to go in the chance to win one of 2 15-minute coaching calls with myself, Ricky Hayes. And congratulations to today's winners of the 15-minute coaching calls. So your names will be showing up on screen. Contact me on Instagram at Ricky Hayes IG so we can arrange our call together so that I can help you. Let's get back into it. Alternative number 3, DHGate. Okay, so DHGate is actually just very similar to AliExpress. You can find items actually cheaper there as well, depending on the item, of course. There's other winning products that actually aren't on AliExpress sometimes that you can find there as well. It integrates with Shopify, which is another order fulfillment app. So you can actually basically automate your order fulfillment using DHGate as well. It's great for all items, okay, and it is less known, so chances of finding better quality suppliers as well, okay? But the cons is it doesn't integrate with Oblo or DSERs for those starting out to try and save money, okay, because Dropify is a paid app. It's a new platform for you to learn. So regardless of your experience with AliExpress, you're gonna have to learn something new about DHGate. Obviously, it has its differences. Shipping can be more expensive at times as well, and it can actually be longer as well. But I wanted to at least give you this alternative, and let's find out more about it now. All right, so we're on DHGate now. So you can see it is very similar to AliExpress. It's got a lot of the items that we need. It's really good for fashion, jewelry, all of that stuff as well. We can actually see as well one of the benefits. It does have 2 to 5 day shipping section. So actual items that they find that we can ship that are 2 to 5 day shipping items, and you can actually get better prices. So if we have a look at this item per se, okay, so see how it obviously is different, that we do have our free shipping options. We also have our various other ones that you can use. E-packet as well, 8 to 21 days, or you can actually, you know, it's very similar, but it's not as saturated. And some of these suppliers actually have even faster shipping than that. That's actually quite cheap as well. So we can actually see here that we've got pretty fast shipping, again with ePacket on DHGate. You can see the layout of it is somewhat similar. We can import it using Dropify, as I said, that actually makes it a lot easier. You just have to make an account, and it's got a lot of other options there as well. So now you know that one. Alternative number 4, Taobao. I think I said that right. It's the original AliExpress, okay? So it's actually the original one. AliExpress was made after Taobao. It's actually more made purely for Chinese individuals. It has cheaper prices than AliExpress. You can contact direct manufacturers, okay? So a lot of the people on AliExpress are people actually buying the items from Taobao or 1677, okay? And you can get faster shipping times from these suppliers, and it's the least known. And used. So if you use it, there's a huge benefit with your product profit margin. So you can get, you know, 20, 30, 40% off the margins that you do use, that you get on AliExpress, pardon me. Okay, so the cons is, it is in native Chinese, so you need to translate it. So like use Google and you can translate it, but even then it's not 100% translated. Communication, again, can be a problem because these people are not really marketing towards Westerners. They're mainly just trying to get other Chinese individuals buy their product, and then they're gonna on-sell them. It's exactly how AliExpress works. Okay, it doesn't integrate with Oblo, DSERs, or Dropify at this point in time, and so the order fulfillment will be manual. But let's go have a look at it now. Okay, so you can see here that I have translated it, but even then, it's still not perfect, but you get the idea with the platform that it's got pretty much nearly everything that AliExpress does. Plus a lot more. If we go have a look at this page here, and you know, we've got a lot of variety of items that you can actually find that aren't potentially on AliExpress, because Taobao gets them first, okay, and then AliExpress. So if you can find a new item on here that's not an AliExpress first, you've got a huge opportunity as well. So it's a bit of product research there. But if we have a look here, we can translate the page. But you can see how, you know, for the most part, it's pretty fine. Shut down. And we can get, you know, if we were to find this on AliExpress, it would be significantly more expensive. The currency as well, this is a bit of a downside. You do have to use a currency converter. Just use Google to convert Chinese yen into whatever your currency is, because it's just in that one by default. Obviously, you can't get a lot of these. You have to get them from AliExpress in terms of the route description. You can get some, but not all. But you can get this much cheaper, and it is an alternative. As I said, you just need, it'll be manual fulfillment as a result. But you can make connections with a lot of these people, and you've got direct connection with actual suppliers that you can get much, much cheaper. So it's a great way to actually network with other suppliers, okay? Alternative number 5, Alibaba, okay? So it's perfect for those who have a winner. Okay, so Alibaba is more for those who have winner, but you can bulk because you can bulk order at massively discounted prices. So you're going straight to a manufacturer, but you also get an extra discount because you're buying in bulk. So if you buy $1,000, they might give you another 10, 20% off. It's quite beneficial for you. It's easy to buy in bulk through the platform, and you can send straight to your private supplier. So whether you're using, let's say, ShipBob in the US, whether you're using CJ Dropshipping, whether you're using a warehouse in China, it doesn't matter. You can send straight to them. And a lot of them actually have warehouses themselves because they're suppliers. So the cons is you need to have capital, okay? So most orders you need at least $500 worth to get a decent discount for it to be worth it, okay? That's not what Alibaba is about. It's bulk order discounts, whereas if you're buying small, that's why you use AliExpress. Okay, you need to have a winner before you really use it, okay? So it's not really worth it otherwise, because you could just buy a heap of stock and you may not make anything, okay? So it's really important that you have a product that you know is gonna do well, all right? And you need to have a private supplier who can warehouse the item. So whether it's a supplier on Alibaba or a private supplier that you have, again, message me on Instagram if you do want that private supplier. I'm happy to help out there as well. But I just wanted to give this one. This is a fantastic one, especially for those who are getting sales, but it's something important for beginners to know when you start getting sales. So I'm on Alibaba, and you can see here, you know, global trade starts here. If we have a look, they've got a lot of different items, as you can expect. We have a look here to give you an idea. So, you know, you got your model number, and it's going to tell you various things like the markets, and it's going to tell you the amount of pieces. Okay, so 5 to 99 pieces, you get $50 each for this. 100, so that's how much, you know, you get essentially a 10% discount by getting 100 plus, and then, you know, 20% discount over 500. Okay, so so if you're buying 500 worth of these, you're spending thousands of dollars, right? Okay, so it's really important that you understand that. I just wanted to give it to you as an option so that wherever you are in your journey, you understand what to do, because this can save you a lot of money. Because if you're selling this for $100, okay, you could sell for $100, $60, whereas if you went on AliExpress, this product probably cost you $60 or something. It's a massive difference, that $20. It does mean more work with arranging fulfillment and various other components, but there's ways around that, okay? And if you really want to build your business, this is really important. And so Alibaba gives you a lot more, and you're really dealing with actual suppliers. So you can see here, this is a video of their actual business, the product, pardon me, but a lot of these are actual, you know, the actual warehouse suppliers. So they can actually warehouse a lot for you too. Just ask the question. That's why they got the contact, because this is a large order value. And that concludes today's video on 5 alternative sources to AliExpress in 2019 for dropshipping. Don't forget to subscribe to today's video, hit the like button, and comment down below. Crush it. If you're on the chance to win one of 2 15-minute coaching calls with myself, Ricky Hayes, we just need 40 comments for that to go ahead. Don't forget as well, there's a link down below for my resources page. On that resources page, you're going to find a lot of links for free content like free books, SMS marketing, messenger marketing, so many forms of marketing to help you get started, and it's all free. That takes you from beginner to intermediate through to advanced. It has my premium stuff down at the bottom as well. Now, lastly as well, I do also do monthly live training. Okay, there's a link in my resources page as well for that as well. I highly recommend you join. You're going to learn a lot of stuff, and you're going to be able to ask me questions completely live. It goes for an hour. You just need to set aside 60 minutes. You're going to learn so much. Okay, and I do this all for you. So thank you so much for watching today. Have a lovely day. Take care and goodbye.